The true story of how the Grinch saved Christmas.
Christmas, it's the worst time of the year. I mean, it's the only time of the year I actually have to do any work. When the rest of the year I can just let those little elves slave away in that little factory of theirs, well, this time of the year I have to go and deliver presents to all those naughty, stupid, greedy children. Well, I'm not gonna take it anymore. This year is gonna be different. Bah humbug!
Santa, get off your fat, lazy butt and go to work. We have to pay our rent. They're about to cut off the electricity.
Shut up, Mrs. Claus. You can't tell me what to do. I'm the man of the house here.
I'm gonna go live with my parents. You call me back when you're ready to be a better husband.
Well, you know what? I don't need you. I have all my friends right here. You know what? After all that's happened, I don't think I'm going to deliver presents this year. Those children don't deserve it. And I deserve a break. You know what? After all that's happened...
As Santa Claus laughed and plotted, a young elf named Grinch silently squatted. He listened to Santa's dastardly plot, and Grinch sat down and thought and thought.
Now that I've heard this horrible plan, I must deliver these toys to man. I must take all the presents that Santa's been keeping and give them to all the little girls and boys so they won't be weeping.
He snuck into Whoville late at night, only turning on a single dim light as he placed the presents in each of their places. He smiled, picturing the kids' happy faces. As he closed the door and turned out the light, he whispered, "Merry Christmas to all, and to all, a good night."
Elf!
Yes, Santa?
That's Mr. Santa to you!
I'm sorry, sir!
Get the announcement system online!
Okay, and good job delivering all those presents to Whoville, sir!
What, Phil?
No, Whoville's in South America, Whoville's in North America!
Wait, Whoville? Do you know where I am right now, little elf?
Where?
I'm in I Don't Careville.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I have an announcement to make, and you're going to tell all the elves that Christmas is canceled. And I have to go deal with whoever gave those presents to those people in Whoville.
You're a mean one, Mr.
Santa.
As a cactus, you're as charming as an eel, Mr.
Santa.
You're a bad banana with a greasy black peel. You're a monster, Mr.
Santa.
Spiders, you've got garlic in your soul, Mr. Grinch.
Santa.
I wouldn't touch you with a 39.5-foot pole. You're a vile one, Mr.
Santa.
Grinch. You have termites in your smile. You have all the tender sweetness of a seasick crocodile, Mr. Grinch.
Santa.
Given the choice between the two of you, I'd take the, seasick crocodile. You're a rotter, Mr.
Santa.
You're the king of sin. red tomatoes splotched with moldy purple spots, Mr. Grinch.
Santa!
You're a three-decker sauerkraut and toadstool sandwich with arsenic sauce!
The Grinch returned to Whoville that night to put Santa Claus's wrongs to right. But as he brought in the loads of toys, a Whovillian child heard the noise.
Why do you have my toys in your paws?
I bring them back from Santa Claus.
But Santa is good, kind, and nice. You're a green monster, a creature of vice.
Please don't hurt me. I'm here as your friend. You'll see. Everything will turn out well in the end.
No!
Please don't hurt me.
No.
Here is a friend.
And so the Grinch was stabbed for just being nice. But the Whovillian child stopped and looked twice. For the Grinch's heart was not three sizes too small. In fact, his heart was 10 sizes too tall. The young child ignored the thought in his head that told him the Grinch might have been good instead. Shrugging, he yawned and went back to bed. The people of Whoville never knew they had missed this, the true story of how the Grinch saved Christmas.
I'm hungry. Mrs. Claus, send the reindeer off to the butcher. I'm looking forward to some reindeer bacon.
Ninja.